preaching proper of the Lord. Gotta teach the speak, exposing all the lies with the truth. Now they can see the evil, we the lost children of the Lord. Y'all should holler, chopping heads off with my sword. Holy Bible, one west, one west, one west, one west, one west.
Most of us slept last night. A group of Americans were giving out food, water, and clothes to Haitian migrants on the Mexican side of the border. Fox San Antonio's Yami Virgin has the exclusive video, an interview with the group some call controversial. Why they say they were forced to go through Mexico after Border Patrol in Del Rio turned them away.
People in Piedras Negras, just across from Eagle Pass, were a little shocked last night around midnight to see men dressed in these clothes. Black and Hispanic men in a caravan of 12 cars and a rental truck stopped on the other side of the border.
O libro, ¿qué libro aparte?
¿Cuál es el libro? Kind of book?
The Bible?
La Reina Valera.
Right, the Holy Bible.
Where you from, buddy?
King James Version.
Where are you from? Where are you coming from?
Austin, Texas.
You're from Austin, originally? Right. From Austin.
Austin, Texas, right.
So where you live?
In Austin, Texas.
In Austin? So you came all the way from Austin to what?
To help? I came out to assist and to help the Haitians because according to the Bible, the Haitians are the Levites in the Bible. The same way the Mexicans are the Issacharites in the Bible. We are the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. We are really God's chosen people who Christ died for. We are one family, one blood family, saying through blood lineage.
Do you want to translate that for him, please, in Spanish?
Mi maestro aquí dice, es mi arwan. Nosotros somos la misma gente. Nosotros somos la misma nación. Son 12 tribus para la nación de Israel. Y hay varios versículos en la Biblia donde dice quién somos nosotros.
¿Saben que esa puede ser quizá la última noche que estén los migrantes aquí? Parece que va a haber una deportación.
Okay. Well, that's sad, right? Tell them that's sad news to hear, right? At the same time, the Lord has made it possible for the priests, the angels that live on earth, that's us, the angels on earth, to come down to show our brothers and sisters, our Haitian brothers and sisters, that we love them, that we're supposed to gather together as one nation. Blacks, Hispanics, Native Indians, Haitians, all of us are one family.
Dice que esto es algo muy triste de oír, pero Dios ha hecho la posibilidad de que nosotros lleguemos aquí y darles el mensaje de la verdad, para que ellos sepan que sí hay gente que los quiere, que sí hay gente que les quiere ayudar.
Amigos, preséntanos a tus amigos.
¿Quiénes son ellos? ¿Cómo son?
Ellos son oficiales.
Háblales, diles que vengan para que
slept last night, a group of Americans were giving out food, water, and clothes to Haitian migrants on the Mexican side of the border. Fox San Antonio's Yami Virgin has the exclusive video, an interview with the group some call controversial. Why they say they were forced to go through Mexico after Border Patrol in Del Rio turned them away.
People in Piedras Negras, just across from Eagle Pass, were a little shocked last night around midnight to see men dressed in these clothes. Black and Hispanic men in a caravan of 12 cars and a rental truck stopped on the other side of the border, continuing their trip to Ciudad Acuña.
We gathered together in San Antonio. We went to local Costco and Sam's and got the stuff that we need as far as the material, as far as the water, the fruit that we gave out, the Pampers, the wipes, and all of the other things, the toiletries. We gathered that together. We bought that today. We went down to Del Rio. When we got there, Border Patrol told us that we could not give the resources to them. They said that we could only give it to a church that we could donate it to. We said we did not want to give it to the church because the people are not at a church. They are under a bridge.
Thousands of Haitians in need of those items are now going back and forth across the river through a deeper side to find those items for their family. The images of the situation in Del Rio moved the controversial group Israelite School of UPK to mobilize their car caravan when they were allegedly turned away in Del Rio and they headed to Eagle Pass.
Came around to the Mexico side. Now we're in Mexico to give our brothers the resources that we have for them.
After an hour plus trip, the caravan made it to this park in Ciudad Acuña, traveling through an area with a State Department travel warning level 4 for violence on the Mexican side due to the cartels.
Being in a dangerous situation, that's being Black, Hispanic, or Native American. I mean, you know, our lives are dangerous. We live in the most dangerous communities. You know, we live in the most dangerous conditions.
As far as the group is concerned, the treatment by the Biden administration and the Trump administration towards asylum seekers is all the same. The
Bible says that a house divided cannot stand. They said a house divided against itself cannot stand. One thing that America does not understand is the left wing and the right wing are on the same bird. And if one wing decides to stop flapping, the bird dies. And that's what's happening. Because of the hatred they have for each other, they're killing their country.
And as soon as they got there and were able to give away everything they had brought, it was time to pack up to go across the Mexican side of the border once again to go home to the U.S. Jamie Virgen, Fox News.
We love our people, and there is nothing wrong with loving your people. America was built on the love of their people, and there's nothing wrong with us coming together and loving each other. We don't call supremacists because we love each other. So what are we doing that's racist? Feeding our brothers, giving them water. We're not criminals, we're not thieves, we're not murderers, we don't sell drugs, we don't do anything that's wrong, that's against the law, but we're called supremacists. It's kind of funny from a people that kids shoot schools up every day and they never call terrorists. It's kind of funny for the people that, you know, do all the killing, they'll never call terrorists. So, you know, we know about propaganda because, like I said earlier, being Black, Hispanic, and Native American, that's the dangerous, you know, name to attach to yourself. And we're up for the tax. You know what I mean? As far as how people try to demonize us, as you see, we're very mannerable and respectful, and we are very professional, and we're very serious about what we do. You know, we understand that there is an agenda out and they don't want us to be masculine, serious men. And that's where we are. So we're being demonized for being men. We're being demonized for loving our brothers and our sisters. We're being demonized for doing what's right. And our king was demonized for doing what's right. Everybody say they love Christ and they love Jesus, but Christ was killed because people didn't like the
the righteousness he was pushing. And that's the same thing with us. They hate us because of the righteousness we push. To be honest, when we pulled up in this park, it was kind of mixed emotions, because it was a beautiful thing to us, because we teach that we should come together and unify. And what we saw was Hispanics unifying with the Haitians. And that was a beautiful thing to see, how they were working in solidarity together. But to know on the flip side, on the back end of it, that it's not, you know, it's not as good as it looked. To us, it's progress to see how we're coming together and starting to have compassion for each other. And we know that it was nothing but the Lord that made it to where we could come and show our solidarity to where now as Black Hispanics and all of us coming together to show our solidarity with each other. But to talk about the scene out here, it's a horrible scene for anybody, and it's a horrible condition for anybody to live in. And to be perpetuated as being one of the richest countries on the face of the earth, it's no excuse for them to be in this condition at all. It's no excuse. If we, as poor Black men, could come out here and give our brothers and sisters the resources that they need in such a short time, America can do way more. And they showed that with what they did with Afghanistan. Because if I'm not mistaken, that Afghanistan people, they will be receiving checks monthly. And I have an article in my phone right now where they said, this is not the norm. We are not prepared, but it's in a state. It is a state of emergency, and we must get it done. Well, being that this is the land of the free, that should go for all people. That's what the Declaration of Independence said. All men are created equal. All men should get that type of love and compassion to receive benefits like that. But we see that that doesn't work when you're Black, Hispanic, and Native American. So, absolutely. Absolutely. And we just saw it. The Lord showed it to us 2 weeks ago. He showed us how they left their own military. They left United States citizens in Afghanistan with terrorists terrorizing them. And they brought those Afghanistan people over here and gave them benefits. If the Haitians were not Black, they would get benefits. This just shows you that there's a perpetual hatred for Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. And that's fine. It's fine. It doesn't matter how they feel about us. Now it's time for us to come together and love each other.
Right.
And that's
right.
It. Right.
Right.
Let me ask you, the political parties,
let me tell you what the Bible says. The Bible says that a house divided cannot stand. They said a house divided against itself cannot stand. One thing that America does not understand, that the left wing and the right wing are on the same bird. And if one wing decides to stop flapping, the bird dies. And that's what's happening. Because of the hatred they have for each other, they're killing their country. This is happening right before their eyes. And it is nothing that they can do to stop it because of how much they hate each other. Everybody's pointing a finger at each other. And that's fine. Because
this place needs to go through what it's going through because of how it treats my people. The way this place have always treated Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you know, this is, you know, you get what you give. What goes around comes around. We're gonna be here tonight. Really, we're about to get ready to leave after I do this interview. We're gonna pack up. We're gonna get out of here. But we're in Texas, so we're everywhere. Anytime you need us, you can just call ISUPK. You can contact ISUPK.com, and we're coming. Because we don't say we love you, and we don't do anything about it. Actions speak louder than words, and we show action with what we say. So, you know, we're going back home tonight, but we're just a phone call away.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, it broke up. I'm sorry. Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right.
This Captain Yacht is like she was doing an interview earlier, but she got a different news.
Yes, ma'am.
No, es los videos que te estoy dando a ti. Okay, sí, ahorita lo saco. Ah, ok, yo creo que van a dormir. Ok, bueno, déjame grabar los videos para cuando se estén queriendo grabarlo, para tener, porque nadie tiene. Déjame con la llamada.
The government no phone. I don't know if you can grab a telephone.
Well, I mean, to tell you the truth, the government was never designed to help us. It was never designed to help us. And that's, we're really glad that they're showing it to us now. Because for so long, we've been looking for them to assist us and give us help. But all along, that help and assistance was never designed for us. Even being from America, the Declaration of Independence, it says all men are created equal. That was written in 1776. But in 1776, our people were in the fields picking cotton. They weren't calling our people men. They weren't calling us people. They called us boys. So when the Constitution was written, it was never even written with us in mind. So in order for them to include us and say that we are created equal with them, they would have to rewrite the Constitution. They would have to rewrite the Declaration of Independence. You know what I mean? So now it's just time for us to realize that we just need to come together. Our people spend $3.8 trillion a year. It's not that we don't have the resources. We just give the resources to everyone else.
Is any way where your organization help the people or do something about what the government, Mexican government, do around these people?
Say that one more time. You said,
what can I do, like your organization, to help these people? For the government, that he's not doing nothing.
He's
taking away to help. He's putting some people for the homeless. He put some people from the
heat. What's up?
Take it off from the tail.
Es puro WhatsApp.
Ahorita ya no tienen llamada. Los camiones ahí en migración donde los van a reportar.
Y si es a bunch of buses right there, en inmigración.
Bueno, muchas gracias. Déjame grabar.
Pues yo creo que nosotros también podemos hacer poco, porque pues ninguna de las ni siquiera la administración de aquí está apoyando absolutamente nada.
Any of the government, creo que city o federal.
What we can do is what we did for each other. Is we gave each other something that money can't buy, and that's brotherhood.
Dice que ellos están haciendo ahorita algo que el dinero no puede comprar. Esa es como la hermandad que puede tenerlo con ellos.
And que les ayudes con la migración.
Sí, pero dice que ellos no pueden hacer nada ahorita.
And also, we gave each other the truth. The Lord gave us the truth, and we're giving it out tonight. And you'll see the Lord for the first time in your life tonight.
Dice que Dios le está dando la verdad a ellos, porque una vez están viendo la verdad, al haber venido ellos a Dios.
This is the true spirit of Christ.
This is verdadero espíritu de Dios.
Bueno, pues muchas gracias como quiera por haber venido y colaborarse sobre solidarizar. Y bueno, pues nosotros vamos a estar ahí con ellos hasta el último, el momento en que nosotros ya no podamos hacer absolutamente nada.
She said, Eddie, thank you for you, all the people come over to help me out here to the people.
Ya les escuché en la mediodía, les quitamos como 15 compañeros que ya los traían en los camiones y se los bajamos, pero solo no podemos. Yo todavía no entro a la administración.
See, and somebody else helped to pull out from the patrols. Mm-hmm. Some people take it out from the police.
Pero es poco lo que se puede
hacer. No problem. Get together.
I want you to stay strong in the spirit of the Lord. Hey, listen, if you like this tape, hit the like button and share it, man. Hit the share button. Everybody share it to their own personal Facebook accounts. Share this video, man, to wake up brothers and sisters all over this earth. Hit the like button. Check me out Monday night. I'm live every Monday night. I bring the heavy hitters in. We do it up live right on this same channel. I'll see you then, Israel. Y'all take care. Shalom.
Grace and prophet of the Lord, gotta teach this people, exposing all the lies with the truth. Now they can see the evil, we the lost children of the Lord. Y'all should holler, chopping heads off with my sword. Holy Bible, one west.
And who is working these videos in here tonight? Who put these videos up on the screen?
Captain Mashaq, sir.
Come on, Marat. You see what Mashaq is doing?
Mexican side right now of the Rio Grande. That's the river that separates this country. Asylum and be able to stay in the United States.
Many of them traveled through South and Central America to get to this point. They're fleeing poverty and years of...
Hi, sir, my man.
Go ahead, Al.
Those two scriptures that you brought out, were you holding for your topic? You want to bring those up?
We had an earthquake. We left with nothing. No home, no food, nothing. Almost all my family died. And if we don't go across, where are we going to go? We don't have a home. That's why we're searching for a better future.
The ISUPK saw the need and crisis going on at the border. Under Commanding General Yohana, we wanted to provide humanitarian aid. We then legally crossed the Mexican-U.S. border to meet our brothers and sisters, the Haitians, who are the Levites, according to the Bible, God's chosen people. Once there, we provided the essential goods, toiletries, food and water. The ISUPK fed the multitude the way Commanding General Yohana taught us about our King Christ feeding the multitude. The people were nourished both spiritually and physically. Officer Yatazar spoke to the people in Creole, teaching them their identity about their God. ISUPK organized the people in a single file line, and they received the desperate help they needed decently and in order. Captain Yatazak led the charge, conducting interviews, confronting the U.S. Border Patrol, and lifting the spirits of the lowly and depressed. We arrived around 12 midnight, the darkest hour, but the light of the truth shined, and the real prophets were revealed.
So what are y'all doing?
We're coming down here to make sure that our brothers are good. We have toiletries. We're coming out here to make sure that they can get what they need. As we saw when we just went over there to speak to them, they said that they were not able to take our donation, but they can give them to a church. Those people are not at a church. Those people are under the bridge. We have cases. We have pallets of water. We have pampers for the children. We have clothes for the women and the men. And we have all the things that they would need under the bridge, not at a church. So we're trying to make sure that we get them the food and the access that they need. So what we're going to do is we're just going to go around, go through the pass, go through Mexico, and give them what they need from the other side of the world. We're the Israelite School Universal Practical Knowledge. We're a Bible-based nonprofit organization. We're based out of Harlem, New York, and we're under Commanding General Yohana. We teach that Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the true Israelites according to the Bible. And those people that are behind this gate, those are our brothers in the tribe of Levi. We, and Texans always love to say that they don't need an excuse to help Texans, and we don't need an excuse to help our brothers. So we here, and we gonna help them.
And what were you trying to do?
We were just trying to give them clothes and the things that they need, you know, water, toiletries. We have a couple of things that can assist them that can make this hard time that they're going through a little lighter.
What did they say?
They told us to go and donate to a church.
What do you think about how
they're going to do this? Well, we see how they handled the situation with Afghanistan. We see that they've allocated over $300 million to the Afghanistan evacuees, meaning they rescued them. And these were people that actually committed terrorist attacks on our soil. These people are coming over here because of an earthquake that they could not control. And this is a horrible incident. And you know, America claims to be the place to pursue the happiness, but they're trying to pursue happiness and safety. And America is turning them around and it proves that this is not the land of the free.
Do you guys have a chapter here in Texas?
Or? Yes, we are the school in Texas. We're here to help those people that are under that bridge. We're here to give them the food, the water, and the clothes, or whatever it is that we can assist them with. That's it. This is a state of emergency. And in this state of emergency, if America doesn't want to help, we will.
How long are you guys planning on being down here to keep providing assistance for these people?
We're going to come down here as much as we can, as long as we can, as long as there's people still under that bridge.
And
can
you get your name, please?
My name is Captain Jack. Y-A-T-A-Z-A-Q.
Thank you.
Where can people look you guys up?
Yeah,
ISUPK.com.
Okay. We have schools all over the world. We have a school in Haiti. We have schools everywhere. We teach this all over who we are for our people to come back to their culture. So it's ISUPK.com.
All right. Last question. What is your message to those in power, whether it's the president or those who are DHS, Border Patrol? What is your message to them?
My message to them is that thank you for showing everyone who you really are. Thank you for letting everybody see your true colors.
And what do you mean by that?
Thank you for showing that this is not the home of the free. This is not, all men are not created equal.
Right.
Thank you for proving the Declaration of Independence has nothing to do with minorities.
Right.
You know, if you're going to call this the land of the free, you shouldn't choose who you want to help.
People have heard the plans from the U.S. government to fly many in the camp back home.
We're scared that if we cross, they'll just deport us back to Haiti and it will be worse for us.
Those we did see crossing the river were mainly bringing food and water to those on the other side. I asked this man how people were doing on the other side.
They're okay, but sad, because maybe tomorrow they'll be deported.
They made sure that they could help the Afghanistan. Now they are calling these people, you know, that they're deporting them back to their homes when they're running from the ground caving under their feet. There's nothing they can do about that. Those people in Afghanistan, they couldn't stay home. They chose to come over. But those people, they didn't have a choice.
Appreciate
it,
man.
No problem.
Good luck.
No problem. Toro, let's go.
Conte mes amis parce que toute jeune Haïti yo là nous te mettre fini étude classique nous pas besoin de travail pour nous faire nous pas besoin rien pour nous faire c'est dans la rue nous lagué et c'est ça qui fait que plus petit monde dans la rue qui a demandé et c'est ça qui fait que pédé li cointé dans la rue c'est parce que l'état pays nous pas penser pour nous si on te mettre travail nous pas pas passer misère dans l'autre pays si on te mettre au moins factory mettre travail pour nous pas mandan pile parce que là nous rive dans pays non notre pays yo travail nous pas faire la Haïti c'est on a fait.
We in DHS are securing additional transportation to accelerate the pace and increase the capacity of removal flights to Haiti and other destinations in the Western Hemisphere. We are communicating, as we have now for months, loudly and clearly, that irregular migration, the perilous journey, is not the journey to take. One risks one's life, the life of one's loved ones, for a mission that will not succeed.
We got a lot of food, we got peppers, we got stuff for the people.
There's a church next to the fairgrounds. Taking donations. Or if you guys have like a collection,
we got the
okay, so checkpoint number 3, okay, which isn't this one where you see vehicles, this is the next one down. That's where they're taking all connections.
We're not able to access it and get to them directly?
No, only government officials and officers are in there right now.
Okay, so we can't get it to them directly at all?
Not directly. Okay.
All right, appreciate it.
Right on, sir. Thank you. All right, let's go.
No, buenas noches a toda la gente que nos está viendo a través de Rezo con Noticias. En este momento me encuentro con un grupo israelí, ¿se puede decir?
La Escuela Israelita de Conocimiento Práctico Universal.
Ok, bueno, estas personas se acaban de reunir aquí en lo que estaría siendo en las Plazas de las Culturas de la ciudad de Piedras Negras. Aquí vamos a entrevistarnos con una de sus líderes. ¿verdad? Su capitán. ¿Cuál es el nombre de este capitán?
Capitán
Yatesat. Okay. Bueno, ¿ustedes dónde son originarios exactamente?
Nosotros comenzamos en Nueva York, en Harlem, New York, desde 1969, debajo del comando de General Yahana. Nosotros tenemos escuelas en todos los estados. Incluso hoy vinimos para ayudar a nuestra gente que está en Acuña. Hoy vinimos a darle comida, vinimos a darle las necesidades que necesitan, que los gobiernos le dan a nuestra gente. Por eso pasan hambre.
Ustedes vienen aquí a ayudar a las personas haitianas, a las que están...
ayudar a toda nuestra gente, incluyendo a nuestra raza mexicana, a nuestra raza hispana. Para nosotros, los hispanos, los negros y los indios nativos son los verdaderos israelitas de la Biblia.
Ustedes vienen predicando la Biblia. ¿Qué habla de su mente, su religión más que nada?
No es una religión, esto es nuestra cultura, es algo que nos pertenece a nosotros. Es la historia que fue robada de nosotros cuando nosotros estábamos en esclavitud.
You speak Spanish because you were conquered by the Spaniards. We speak English because we were conquered by the English.
Nosotros hablamos español porque fuimos conquistados por los españoles. Ellos hablan inglés porque fueron conquistados por el hombre blanco que es de Inglaterra, por eso hablan inglés.
But we are all one family, and we come in to teach our people that blacks, Spanish, Native Americans, we got the same problem and we should come together.
Pero nosotros somos la misma gente y vinimos a enseñarle a todos que los hombres hispanos, negros e indios nativos somos la misma gente y tenemos que unirnos otra vez.
Okay. Bueno, pues aquí como ustedes pueden escuchar a toda la gente, mira, aquí se encuentran estas personas que vienen a ayudar a la comunidad que se encuentra en la ciudad de Acuña, con agua, comida, etcétera, ¿verdad? Ustedes, bueno, su cultura, dicen que viene desde, están establecidos en Nueva York, ¿verdad?
Ahí comenzamos.
Ahí comenzaron.
Pero tenemos en todos lugares, todos estados de América, en Canadá, en Brasil, en Puerto Rico, nosotros estamos en todo el mundo. Y ahora vamos a comenzar aquí en México también, a enseñarle a nuestra gente quiénes son verdaderamente.
Entonces ustedes vienen aquí a México, pues son aquí Piedras Negras, para empezar a establecer una nueva cultura de usted, ¿verdad? Para aquí quedar como, digamos, una embajada, por así decirlo, de su cultura.
Correcto, enseñarle a nuestra gente la cultura de nosotros de veras, antes que el hombre blanco nos diera la cultura de ellos.
Bueno, y exactamente de qué va su cultura, más que nada.
Says, what is our culture based on?
The Bible. The Bible is our history book.
La Biblia. La Biblia es nuestro libro de historia. Y ese libro nos pertenece a nosotros solamente, a ninguna otra nación.
The same people that built the pyramids, the same Aztecs that built the pyramids, are the same people that built the pyramids in Egypt.
Nosotros somos la misma gente que construimos los pirámides en Egipto. Y nosotros somos la misma gente que construimos las pirámides aquí. Por ejemplo, los aztecas, los mayas, incluso hubo muchos tribus que tenían sus propias pirámides.
Ok. ¿Y exactamente de qué habla su Biblia, más que nada?
Sí.
The Bible talks about the history of the Israelites. And blacks, Spanish, Native Americans are really called, our real nationality is Israelites.
La Biblia habla de israelitas. Es nuestra cultura. Y la Biblia dice, los hombres negros, indios nativos, hispanos, somos los israelitas. De eso es lo que hablamos nosotros, solamente de la Biblia. La misma Biblia que leen en la iglesia cristiana, la iglesia católica, nada más que ellos no tienen el entendimiento de la Biblia. Esa es la cosa. Nosotros vinimos a enseñarles cómo leerla realmente. Porque Dios no es un Dios de amor. Dios es un Dios de guerra. Eso es lo que dice en el libro de Éxodos. Si nosotros vinimos a enseñar solamente la Biblia como es.
In the same way God fought for us in the Bible, that's what he's going to do for us right now in these times.
De la misma manera que Dios peleó por nosotros en la Biblia, por ejemplo, con plagas y todo eso, Dios va a pelear por nosotros en estos tiempos también.
Aquí una de las cosas que me interesó es su vestimenta. ¿Puede decir que es una vestimenta típica de su cultura?
This is our ancient attire. Each one of our tribes have different attire. Some of the northern Cajun tribes still keep that attire, but this is our ancient warlike attire that we used to always wear because we are warriors.
Estos mantos son mantos bíblicos. Todo tribu, son 12 tribus en la nación de Israel. Cada tribu tiene su propio manto. Hay mucho de nuestra gente que todavía usa mantos. Lo que usamos es todo bíblico. Todo está en la Biblia.
Okay. Porque la gente vea más que nada cómo es el bíblico de estas personas, vean nada más cómo vienen vestidas. Es lo que ha llamado la atención de muchas personas que han pasado por aquí, las que han preguntado, ¿verdad? Por esa, es lo que ha pasado, porque sinceramente aquí en la ciudad de Pedernales no estamos acostumbrados a ver ese tipo de cosas. Es muy interesante lo que ustedes vienen aquí a ayudar, y la verdad agradecemos mucho que vienen aquí a ayudar a sus hermanos en la ciudad de Acuña. Esto sería todo por mi parte. Muchas gracias, la verdad, se me puede dar la mano. Gracias. Mi nombre es Sebastián Flores, para todo lo que gusten, aquí estamos. Si gusta dar un mensaje a la gente de aquí en la ciudad de Pedernales.
I want to let everybody know that the Lord is fighting for his people, and it's time for us to fight back.
El mensaje es que sepan todos que Dios está peleando por su gente y es tiempo que nos unamos nosotros y peleemos para atrás para regresar a él.
And it's time for us, Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, to come together and stand against the oppression that has been put upon us and love one another.
Y es tiempo que los hombres negros, hispanos e indios nativos nos unamos otra vez y pelear contra nuestros opresores y tenernos amor entre nosotros mismos como hermanos.
Ok, bueno, muchas gracias. Vamos a retirar. Bueno, ahí estuvieron observar a esas personas que vienen aquí a defender los derechos de sus amigos, sus hermanos. Comenzaron, es una cultura israelita, al parecer, que tiene su propia... tiene su propia religión.
Any man give his life for Yahweh Shah, Mashiach in Christ, and fall up under that UPK banner. It's my brother and my blood, and I will die and kill for him if necessary.
Take ground. We would not be moved or intimidated. We ain't the type. You got a problem, tell them.
She conceals, she lies. I know two things. A robber will not prosper. Any man harm me and my aunt gonna meet the duck. Cause this life is warfare, it's not an easy walk. And watching my people die, so you can miss me with that love talk. My new BK soldiers, any man try to crush your past, make him regret with that minute fall on his age. Comparing me to you really ain't no contest. Lonely one west.
Say what?
Lonely one west. This for those who thinking we ain't ready for them. Tell them back up, I'm about to drop some heavy for them. Nous-mêmes haïtiens, nous-mêmes Israël, nous-mêmes
Oye, oye, nadie tiene. Cadeno. moun sa yo, ouais tout ça qui était là, tout ça c'est gratis yo. Après les bagages, moun tap sur l'autre bord, l'eau vient prendre bagage là, le vendre malheureusement bien cher. Hein? Et pour la geste pour nous faire comprendre, nous toi des bon haïtien. Tendez bien. Tout bagage ça là net, tout c'est gratis, tu pas rien là pour vendre. Vous entendez? Yo mette mon charge. Ça veut dire depuis aujourd'hui, on fait nous un boss. Regardez, nous, depuis que nous venons là-bas, nous venons prendre la paix à l'avant pour nous suspendre ça. Parce que nous venons de l'autre bord, pas de nager. Il y a moins de goût, il y a moins de goût, il y a moins de goût. Nous-mêmes, nous qui avons aidé, nous avons prendre des messages pour nous porter par nous. Nous avons fait l'autre monde pour nous venir prendre tout pour nous vendre. Faut nous suspendre ça, mes amis. Faut nous mettre nous ensemble, nous sommes venus. Est-ce que vous avez un modèle d'après-midi? 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 Vous avez un modèle.
To die like a man, to live like a coward. There's a ghetto up in heaven and it's ours. I'd rather die like a man, to live like a coward. There's a ghetto up in heaven and it's ours. Black power, 144,000. I'm just trying to make 144,000. 144,000. I'm just trying to make 144,000. Hearing lies on the news and lies from the reverend. I might not be a nigga by the time I get to heaven, man. It's time for the truth. I'm tired of oppression. They won't call me a nigga by the time I get to heaven. Hearing lies on the news and lies from the reverend. I might not be a nigga by the time I get to heaven, man. It's time for the truth. I'm tired of oppression. They won't call me a nigga by the time I get to heaven. Rather die like a man than live like a coward. There's a ghetto up in heaven and it's ours. I'd rather die like a man than live like a coward. There's a ghetto up in heaven and it's ours. Black power, 144,000. I'm just trying to make 144,000. 144,000. I'm just trying to make 144,000. Rather die like a man than live like a coward. There's a ghetto up in heaven and it's ours. I'd rather die like a man than live like a coward. There's a ghetto up in heaven and it's ours. Black power.
Preaching proper hood and door, gotta teach the speak, exposing all the lies with the truth. Now they can see the evil, we the lost children of the Lord. Yasha Allah, chopping heads off with my sword. Holy Bible,